Hello friends, myself R.D. Mahajan presenting my video on the topic method of variation of parameter. Let us solve the problem. D cube plus D into y is equal to cosec x. Here the order of that differential equation is 3, and therefore to find its solution by method of variation of parameter, we have to apply a new formula or new technique. Given differential equation is d cube plus d into y is equal to cosec x. The term on the right hand side is cosec, does not come under any shortcut form, and hence we have to apply method of variation of parameter. Auxiliary equation is d cube plus d is equal to 0. Taking d common from this, we get d square plus 1 is equals to 0. It implies first term equals to 0, d equals to 0, first root, and second, d square plus 1 is equals to 0, d square is equal to minus 1, and it implies we get d is equals to root of minus 1 plus minus I, imaginary. Roots are imaginary. And therefore, it is a combination of real and imaginary roots. First is a real, first one is a real, and second are imaginary. And therefore, complementary function CF is given by C1 e raised to M1x, value of M1 is here 0. Here alpha plus I beta type of compare and get the values of alpha and beta. We get alpha at 0, therefore e raised to alpha x, e raised to 0 x, multiplied by c1 cos beta plus c2 sin of beta x. C1 already used, therefore c2 next constant, cos of beta x, the value of beta is 1, therefore c2 cos of x plus c3 sin of x. And we call this as equation 1. CF. Then comparing this with the assumed CF for cubic equation must be C1 Y1, C2 Y2 plus C3 Y3. Therefore, comparing obtained CF with this assumed CF, we get therefore the value of Y1, coefficient of C1 is y1, here e raised to 0 means 1, we get value of y1 as 1. Y2 coefficient of C2, here the coefficient of C2 is cos x, and y3 is the coefficient of C3, and here it is sin x. Differentiating it with respect to x, we get y1 dash as 0, y2 dash derivative of cos as minus sin x, and y3 dash as derivative of sin cos x, first order derivative. Again differentiating it with respect to x, we get y1 double dash 0, y2 double dash derivative of sin as cos x with minus sign, and y3 double dash as derivative of cos as minus sin x. Then we find the value of that capital A, which is determinant of y1, y2, y3, y1 dash, y2 dash, y3 dash, and in third row, second order derivatives, y1 double dash, y2 double dash, and y3 double dash. Substituting all the values, obtaining the value of A by that determinant, rows are y1, y2, y3 first, second, y1 dash, y2 dash, y3 dash, third, y1 double dash, y2 double dash, and y3 double dash. are substituting all the six nine values here and then evaluating this determinant as per the technique how we are evaluating the third order determinant. Therefore, 1 multiplied by neglecting the row and the column containing it, taking the determinant of the remaining minus sin x cos x minus cos x and minus sin x, then second minus cos x, neglecting the first one, the second column, and determinant of the remaining elements. Remaining elements are 0, cos x, 0, and minus sin x, and plus third one, sin x, neglecting the first one, the third column, and determinant of the remaining four elements, 0, minus sin x, 0, minus cos x. And then evaluating the second order determinant, we get 1 multiplied by a product of this sin into sin, it becomes sin square, minus minus it becomes plus cos square x, then minus cos x, 0 and minus 0, plus sin x, again product of this two, 0 and minus minus plus, a product of this two as 0. And therefore simplifying it further, we know that sin square x plus cos square x is 1, therefore 1 into 1 we get that value as 1. The value of A is 1. Then we try to obtain PI, particular integral, by a formula u into y1 plus v into y2 plus w into y3, where the values of u, v, w are given by. Remember the technique. When we find u, we consider the first two rows of this determinant, neglecting the first column and then taking the determinant of the remaining four, and that is integration of the, once again I will repeat, to find the value of u, we consider first two rows, neglecting the first column, whatever the remaining four elements, take its determinant. That determinant is y2 y3 dash minus y3 y2 dash, that we substitute here, multiplied by phi of x, the term on the right hand side, and divided by a, and then performing it, y2, substituting all the values, y2 is here cos x, y3 dash is cos x, minus y3 sin x, y2 dash minus sin x, into phi of x, the term on the right hand side is phi of x, it is cos 6x here, and divided by a, the value of a is 1. And then simplifying it, cos square plus sin square, we get that as 1, multiplied by cos x, and therefore the integration of it is log of cosec x minus cot of x, the value of u. Similarly, we find v is given by, again the technique, the second term with minus sign, neglecting the second column, and then take the determinant of the remaining four elements, y1, y3, y1 dash, y3 dash, therefore that product is y1, y3 dash, minus y3 y1 dash, multiplied by phi of x, divided by a, and its integration with respect to x. Therefore, substituting the corresponding value, substituting all the values, the value of y1 1, y3 dash cos x, y3 sin x, y1 dash 0, phi of x cosec x and divided by a, a is 1. And therefore, we have minus integration of 1 into cos x is cos x. This one is 0, minus 0 means we get cos x. Multiply by cosec x means cosec means 1 by sin. And its integration with respect to x. Therefore, minus cos by sin is cot of x. And its integration sin x. Value of v with minus sign. Then we find, to find v, we neglect the third column. And then take a determinant of that remaining four elements. The determinant is y1, y2 dash minus y2, y1 dash multiplied by phi of x divided by e and its integration with respect to x. And therefore, substituting all the values, y1 is 1, y2 dash is minus sin x, minus y2, y2 is cos x, and y1 dash is 0, e is 1, and phi of x is cosec x. And therefore, that integral becomes minus sin x and into cosec x. Cosec means 1 by sin and its integration with respect to x. And therefore, minus integration of sin sin get cancelled, integration of dx and its integration is minus x. Therefore, I have obtained the values of u, v, w. We substitute here in this equation of pi to find that expression for pi. Therefore, pi is u is log cosec minus cot into y1, value of y1 is 1, plus v, the value of v is minus log sin x into cos y2, the value of y2 is cos x, w, the value of w is minus x into y3, it is sin x. And we call this equation 2. And then we combine CF and PI to get the complete solution. And therefore, it is CF equation number 1 and PI equation number 2. And therefore, it becomes y is equal to CF is C1 plus C2 cos x plus C3 sin of x as complementary function CF and plus this PI, and therefore it is plus log of cosec x minus cot of x minus cos of x multiplied by log of sin x and minus x sin of x as the required solution. Therefore, for cubic equation we have to apply this technique. And if it is equation of order 2, we have to apply the previous formulas, whatever I have discussed in my previous videos. In my next video, I will present it on second type of linear differential equation with a variable coefficient. There are two different types, Cauchy's differential equation and Legendre's differential equation. Therefore, in next video, I will present it on Cauchy's linear differential equation. Therefore, if you are watching my videos, please like and share it, as well as subscribe to my channel to receive new videos or new updates. Thank you. Thank you very much.